BBTV we're over at the Phoenix camp here in Manchester. Very pleased to say I'm joined by Rob Rimmer, head coach down there. How's it going, Rob?
Good mate, good fantastic. You know, first day I've been away yesterday, just got back coming this morning. The gym's hammered, as you can see, mate. Great.
Been on holiday?
Yeah, mate, just got back from Dubai, yeah. Just went to go and see a friend, but like I said, it's coming up this morning, mate, and we've got the gym's full of talent. Great, it's fantastic. Some, as you can see, some quality sparring going on this morning.
Absolutely good, isn't it? It's like a bit of a few zoo of Northwest boxing, isn't it?
Do you know what?
Great lads today, champions.
Of course, mate, fantastic, and that's what you want, because they're all pushing each other on. Everyone wants to be the best, everyone wants to express themselves, and that pushes each other on. But you can see the atmosphere in here, so it's great, you know what I mean? Can't wish for anything better, mate, so yeah, it's good.
Some of them smiles as well, you know, with some boxing fans, I love to be watching some of them.
Some of the best talent coming out of the Northwest in here. Like you see, you pay for to watch some of them spars, you know what I mean? Whether it be 6 rounds, 4 rounds, unbelievable. So, you know, like I say, it's all on our doorstep. And we're all helping each other out, it's great, fantastic.
And in there, just sparring, not long ago, Ryan Doyle, new Commonwealth champion. Your first champion as coach of the Phoenix camp.
Yeah, mate, first recognised champion.
What a night it was, mate, honestly, really was. I mean, I ended up watching it on the TV, but, you know, jumping up and down, it was a great fight. Credit to both lads, but brilliant for Ryan lifting that title after, you know, a tough career, really, when you look back.
Do you know what, he's had a really tough career. For anyone that knows Ryan, he's been in tough fights, and even the ones, you know, like against Isaac at low, he took that short notice and they give a draw. A lot of people said that he won the fight, but same again, he's still a part of the cards for the future. What could be a fantastic fight. Took a fight with James Tennyson, short notice. He's gone on to world level and he was doing himself justice in that fight. But about this time round now, he got an opportunity. You know, Ryan come out of work, first time he's come out of work, so he's a full-time pro. You know, he got that opportunity, he got that six weeks to prepare. And, you know, we went into that fight confident. At not one point did we feel that, you know, oh no, this could be a bigger challenge than what we thought. But, you know, it was the confidence was sky high. And I'd take nothing away from Reece Bellotti. You know, he's a great champion, he's a great fighter. And I'm more than positive, you know, he will come back bigger and stronger. But I just felt like that was always going to be Ryan's night. You know, leading up to the fight, everything went perfect. And, you know, he nailed it. And he nailed it well. And he deserves it. So, you know, we move on and we go to the next one. And another tough opponent, Jordan Gill, which is going to be, again, another tasty fight. Two total different styles. And again, we're under no illusion that it's going to be a tough test. But Ryan's in it, you know, he wants to fight the best. You know, he wants to be the best, so, you know, we're on that collision course, and anyone who steps in his ways, he's winning the goal.
Jordan Gill, yeah, unbeaten lad again. He doesn't have it easy, Ryan, but, you know, is it an opponent you've looked at and are confident that he's got the, you know, obviously got the experience there and you know, being in them tough fights. What does he bring to the table which is going to, you know, make your camp sit up and, you know, take this fight how you need to take it?
No, take nothing away from him. You know, he's got a great team behind him. You know, look, he's got great lads in his gym as well. You know, he's got a great trainer, Dave Caldwell, who's very experienced. I'm sure, you know, they're going to come with great confidence in the game plan. But honestly, I believe that we've got more than enough to be dealing with Jordan Gill. Yeah, you know, he's a very skillful fighter. He's a great, you know, he's a fantastic boxer. So's Ryan Doyle. And Ryan Doyle's also a great fighter. He's got a great engine. You know, he brings a lot to the table. As you've seen before, you know, he can upset the apple cart like he did against Reece Bellotti. Going into the Lions backyard, and to do what he did was fantastic. Now, you know, Ryan's going in there now as the champion, and his confidence is high. And I you know, we won't be leaving no stone unturned. You know, I went to bed thinking about Reece Bellotti. You know, I never met him before, and when I met him, I thought, wow, you know, I felt like I knew him all my life. And it'll be the same with Jordan Gill. I'll watch him, I'll study him, and we'll put every single bit of work. You know, we won't leave nothing. And, you know, on the night, may the best man win. May the best man win.
Looking forward to that one, mate.
Yeah, can't wait.
Brian Rose, your old mate there, you've known for a long, long time. He's back training at the gym with you. He's not here today. But
yeah, he's not here today. He should be, you know, he'll be back at the end of the week. But Brian's back in now. He's looking looking to make a comeback. You know, he's fit, he's just getting the weight down. We're just waiting. He's just waiting for a few bits of confirmation from the board and from brain scans, and all being good, everything comes back okay. Then you'll see him back out, probably towards maybe November time.
Right. What's it like having Brian back in the gym? And what's he? I mean, you've known him a long, long time. What's he like at this stage of his career now, and back in the gym and getting back into it?
Do you know what? Brian's had a massive career. You know, he's achieved what I think every single fighter would love to achieve and beyond. But, you know, he's come back in here, and he believes that, you know, he's still got it in him to go. Now, obviously, Brian's given me massive opportunity from the start when I was working with my dad, and, you know, I've got to travel the world, been involved in British title fights, English title. You know, I've got that chance through him. So, you know, obviously, the gym's firing at the moment. We've got a load of young lads in here, all hungry, up and coming, talented fighters. And for Brian to come back in here, you know, these sort of fighters look up to him. You know, he brings experience. You know, he's been there, done it. You know, and sometimes it's all well and good me saying things, or, you know, you can't buy experience. And one thing Brian's got is experience. And same again for him. He's going to come in here. It feels like he's got to push a little bit harder to keep up the rest of the lads and to prove to them that, look, you know, listen, I've still got it. You know what I mean? So it's great. It's fantastic. It's great for the gym. And it's great for the lads. So I'm happy to be back out, wait.
Yeah, so he's buzzing, the buzzing lads are on, buzzing, yeah. Your book.
Everyone is, yeah, it's just got a great little atmosphere at the moment.
Yeah, it's great. What's the initial plan then with Brian? You know, he's obviously boxed at the very, very highest level, so how do you bring someone like that back onto the scene at this stage of his career?
Do you know what, this is really what he's going into. You know, Brian's been there, so it's hard being able to get yourself up for 6 round and 8 round fights when you've been in 12 round fights, British title fights. You know, world level, it's hard that, you know, he's travelled from Blackpool, come down here, train and get himself up for it. But he knows that these are all the obstacles that are in his way. He has to face all this, and he truly believes that, you know, he can make them sacrifices and he can mentally prepare himself, you know, not only as physically prepared himself. So, you know, we're going to go into it and take one step at a time. So we're going to get fit, you know, he's going to spar competitive, you know, British European sparring, let's see where he's at there. And then in terms of dates and going forward, I'm sure MTK will have a plan for him. But look, at this point in your career, he's always going to be a stepping stone for someone who's going to come below him coming up, you know what I mean? So he's never going to get an easy fight. Nothing's going to be easier. It's going to be hard. But that's the whole point of coming back, to see if he's still got it. So, sorry mate, so I shouldn't have got knocked down there. I was just nosy. But yeah mate, so it's not only that, like I said, you've got Mark Efron here now as well. Another talented fighter. And that again gives you a good indication as to where you're at. You know, Mark's WBC international champion. He's mandatory to fight for the British at middleweight. Brian's coming back as a middleweight, so, you know, they're both stable mates, but same for Brian, it gives him a good indication as to where he's going to have to be.
He's got to middleweight now, I take it.
He's going to come back at middleweight anyway. I mean, whether he goes back down to look like middleweight is a question for the future, do you know what I mean? But surely he will be coming back at middleweight.
So you say Mark Efron's over there training with you as well?
Yeah mate, he's
a recent addition.
Yeah mate, another fantastic addition. Like say, he's unbeaten. You know, and what a fantastic talent he is. You know, amazing talent. I think he's got potential to go actually all the way, you know, like literally. But like I said, that's another thing again for Brian. You know, gives him that stepping stone to say, you know, look, this is the benchmark, this is where you've got to be. You know what I mean? Because Mark's approaching now for that British level. I know that he's been made mandatory to fight the winner of Lamford and Melbourne for, I think, around December time. So yeah, he's got big things on the cards awaiting. Just like I said, it's just great, mate, for the gym. I'm sorry, massive for me as well. You know what I mean? Massive for me. Things are just slowly, surely, just coming.
Yeah.
All the hard work's starting to pay off. So
definitely. We've got Jack Massey, one of the cruiserweight prospects as well.
Yeah.
He's got something coming up. It's buzzing on that side. There's a lot going on back there, but we're.
Jack's another fantastic talent. You know, he's had a little bit of inactivity, obviously, you know, with the nose, starting to get the nose, just a little bit of put again today. But it's just one of the things we've just got to go ahead with. But yeah, we're looking to get Jack out at the end of September, and then looking towards November time. But I'd say again, MTK, we'll leave that to them, but we're looking towards titles before the end of the year, before December's out, we're looking for titles. So that'd be fantastic as well.
No, it's great to see you, mate. It's great
no,
to see
you too.
The camp going like this, and you know, carrying on the great work that your dad started. How is your dad anyway?
He's good, mate. Yeah. No, he's in LA. He's not back till I think the Rampage fight is the end of September. So I think he's back about. Yeah, by the end of this month now, end of September, we'll be back. But no, it's good, mate, it's great. It's great to be able to carry some on, you know what I mean? And if you think about all the lads that have been in the gym, not only from Billy Graham and my dad, you know, Joe Gallagher was in here, you know, and we've all produced champions. Obviously, now I've got it, I've carried the little legacy on at the Phoenix camp. Just this gym just has a buzz, it just has an aura about it, you know what I mean? So if I can succeed in just a snip of what they succeeded, I'm an happy man.
Yeah, it's absolutely buzzing, the vibes in it, yeah, doubt about it, and it's good to see Rob, it's good to see.
Thanks very much, mate. Yeah,
give me regards to your dad there.
I will do.
Big look forward to catching up with him soon.
I will do, mate. Thanks very much. Great to have you anyway.
Oh, brilliant.
Cheers, man.
Pleasure, thank you. See you soon.
Cheers, mate.